Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about the permeation mechanism of cisplatin through a diol-eol phosphocholine biologic. Cisplatin is a widely used chemotherapeutic drug in the treatment of many types of cancers. The first step of the mode of action of cisplatin is the entry of the drug in the cancer cells. This occurs by passive diffusion through the cell membrane and by facilitated transporters. Despite his hydrophilic nature, cisplatin is able to diffuse to the lipid bilayer due to small size and neutral charge. Once in the cytosol, cisplatin is activated by hydrolysis, in which chloride ligands are replaced by water to form this complex. After hydrolysis, this cationic species is able to enter the cell nucleus and undergoes a nucleophilic attack by purine bases of the DNA, especially guanine, to form different types of DNA lesions. The most common is the intrastrand crosslinks. The formation of this adduct between DNA and cisplatin induces structural distortion in the DNA helix, which is recognized by high mobility groups, which can initiate programmed cell death or apoptosis. In the present study, we unveiled intermolecular interactions that regulate the integration of cisplatin inside a model membrane composed of DOPC lipids by means of umbrella sampling classical molecular dynamic simulations, because the nature of these interactions regulate the uptake efficiency of the drug in the cancer cells and are involved in resistant mechanisms. Moreover, we unveil the role played by the dehydration process of the drug and the change in the ordering of the biologier in the permeation process. The lipid bilayer is formed by 64 molecules of DOPC per layer with a 25 angstrom of water thickness on each side. Furthermore, a concentration of 0.50 molar of potassium chloride is added to reproduce the physiological concentration of this salt. Then, cisplatin is manually placed at 32 angstrom of distance from the center of mass of the membrane. Once the system is set up, the following step is to equilibrate the structure and density of the solvated bilayer. At first, the system is minimized. Then, a heating is carried out, and finally, a production by classical molecular dynamics. After the equilibration of the system, the permeation of cisplatin through a DOPC lipid bilayer is simulated by umbrella sampling molecular dynamics. The reaction coordinate is defined as the distance between the center of mass of cisplatin and the center of mass of the membrane along the z-axis. This distance is divided into 65 windows separated by 0.5 angstroms. And on each of these windows, a molecular dynamic simulation of 15 nanoseconds is carried out applying a harmonic bias potential with a 2.5 kcal per mole angstrom force constant. The value of 2.5 kcal per mole angstrom is chosen as force constant for the bias potential to keep the system inside each window while allowing overlap with the neighboring windows. Such a good overlap is required to obtain an accurate free energy profile along the reaction coordinates. The accuracy of the calculated free energy is determined by the number of snapshots considered per window and the way they are chosen. When the reaction coordinate is modified to drive the system from one window to the next one, it is usually necessary a short calibration in the new window. It is advisable to compute the free energy profile without considering those snapshots. Moreover, an accurate free energy profile is obtained only if the simulation in each window has been run for sufficient time. These important issues are discussed here. Note that in these profiles, the reactants and the products are located on the right and on the left side of the plots, respectively. Therefore, the uptake of cisplatin occurs from right to left. As can be seen in the left plot, it is necessary to eliminate the first 3 nanoseconds of the simulation to obtain a converged profile for the free energy region located between 12 and 24 angstrom. Next, we analyze for how long each window must be evolved to get a converged free energy profile. The right plot shows that the convergence is achieved after running 8 nanoseconds of dynamic simulation. So, it is not necessary to extend the simulation for longer time than 50 nanoseconds per window. Therefore, the time interval will be from 3 to 50 nanoseconds on each window. When this platin approaches the membrane, there is an initial attraction between the drug and the biologic, which results in a free energy minimum. This minimum corresponds to the phase absorption of this platin on the polar region of the membrane, and it is reached after overcoming a small free energy barrier located at 20 angstrom, in which this platin is at the top of the biologic. If this platin continues the diffusion pathway towards the center of the biologic, the free energy still increases until achieving its absolute maximum in the middle of the membrane. If we have a look at the umbrella sampling windows located at the top and mean regions, we realize that the environment and behavior of this platin is different in both regions. While this platin is located at the water membrane interface at top, left figure, it is completely inside the polar region of the biologic at mean, right figure. This situation results in a higher mobility and a shorter interaction time with the lipids when the drug is located at the top region than when it is at mean region. To illustrate this, we saw in these new figures the time evolution of the number of interatomic contacts between this platin and the lipid residue that present the highest interaction energy with the drug. The lifetime of the intermolecular contacts indicates that the motion of the drug is restrained when it is located at the free energy minimum, while it presents a higher degree of freedom when it is on the top region. To get more insight on the nature of intermolecular interactions that drive the diffusion of cisplatin through the lipid bilayer, the interaction potential energy between cisplatin and the membrane has been decomposed into different contributions along the permeation pathway. First, we analyze the contribution of the polar PC heads and nonpolar OL tails to the total interaction energy. The different chemical groups that belong to these two regions of the lipid chain are shown here. In addition, each of these contributions can be further decomposed into van der Waals and electrostatic interactions. As seen in these figures, the interaction energy between cisplatin and the PC head groups dominates along the entire reaction coordinate over the interaction between cisplatin and the OL tails, except in the region of the absolute maximum, where the OL contribution is more important than the PC one. The left plot shows that the interaction between the drug and the polar head is dominated by electrostatic interactions. However, the right plot shows that the most important contribution to the interaction between cisplatin and the nonpolar tails is given by van der Waals interactions. Therefore, the first half of the permeation pathway is regulated by electrostatic interactions, while in the second half of the pathway, van der Waals interactions gain relevance. Since the polar heads are formed by different chemical groups, choline, phosphate, and glycerol groups, it is interesting to evaluate the contribution of each of these moieties to the cisplatin-PC interaction energy along the reaction coordinate. The glycerol groups play an almost irrelevant role along the entire reaction pathway in comparison to the choline and phosphate groups. For these last two groups, the electrostatic interaction with cisplatin largely surpassed the van der Waals ones. Therefore, it can be stated that the electrostatic attractive interaction between cisplatin and choline drives the initial approach of the drug to the bilayer, and then the electrostatic attraction with the phosphate moieties is responsible for the deeper integration of cisplatin in the free energy minimum. Also, we can see that from min to max, the attraction exerted by the phosphate groups is partially compensated by the repulsion with the choline units. The intermolecular interaction of cisplatin with the head group and the nonpolar tails of the DOPC membrane shown before are attractive along the entire permeation pathway and, therefore, do not explain the free energy barrier of 10.4 kcal per mole found in the middle of the bilayer. So the integration of the drugs should also be regulated by solute dehydration and membrane rigidity. We start with cisplatin dehydration. First, the solvation sphere of the drug has been characterized from the radial distribution function between the platinum atom from cisplatin and the oxygen atom from water, which has been computed for reaction coordinate in which cisplatin is in the bulk solvent. We can see that the radial distribution function presents a maximum at 5 angstrom and a minimum at 6 angstrom. The integration of this peak gives that the number of water molecules in the first solvation sphere is around 17 and 18. Then we compute the number of water molecules within a sphere of 6 angstrom along the reaction coordinate. As the new figure shows, when cisplatin goes from the bulk solvent to the maximum, it loses 14 water molecules from its solvation sphere. This desolvation is associated with a large interaction energy penalty, which is compensated by the entropy gain related to the loss of water molecules and the favorable cisplatin lipid interaction analyzed before. Now we study the membrane rigidity. The order of lipid chains has been analyzed in terms of the orientation of the carbon-hydrogen bonds with respect to the normal of the membrane by means of the so-called deuterium order parameter, SCD, of the acyl change. Large value of the SCD parameter indicates a high degree of order of the lipid change. Here we see three different simulations which correspond to situations where cisplatin is in the bulk solvent, in the free energy minimum interacting with the polar heads, and in the middle of the Veloger interacting with the acyl change. When cisplatin goes from the solvent to the minimum at the first half of the permeation pathway, we see a decrease of the SCD parameter. This means that the ordering of the membrane is decreased and results in a favorable entropy contribution to the total free energy. When cisplatin is transported from min to max, the second half of the permeation pathway, SCD parameter is kept constant from carbon 2 to carbon 10 of the acyl change, but it increases from carbon 11 to carbon 16. This ordering increase indicates an entropy decrease that contributes unfavorably to the free energy of the process. In conclusion, the intermolecular interaction between cisplatin and cell membranes play an important role on different steps of the mode of action of these anti-cancer drugs, including the uptake process, resistance mechanism, and initiation of apoptosis. In this work, we have simulated the diffusion process of cisplatin through a DOPC lipid biologer by means of umbrella sampling molecular dynamic simulations to unveil the mechanism of the permeation of cisplatin through the lipid membrane. Cisplatin is first weakly trapped on a free energy minimum where it is completely integrated inside the polar region of the biologer and present a lower mobility than when it is around the barrier region, which corresponds to the interface between the solvent and the membrane. During this initial stage, where cisplatin is around the first maximum and the minimum of the free energy surface, the first half of the permeation pathway, the integration of cisplatin into the membrane is driven by strong electrostatic interactions with choline and phosphate groups. Moreover, it is also regulated by the unfavorable energy and entropy due to the dehydration of the solvation sphere, and the favorable entropic contribution caused by the decrease of the membrane ordering. The second half of the permeation pathway, where the drug moves from the minimum to the global maximum, is regulated by weak van der Waals attractive interaction between cisplatin and the nonpolar tails. Furthermore, it is also regulated by the unfavorable energy and entropy due to dehydration of the solvation sphere, and the unfavorable entropic contribution caused by the increase of the lipid ordering. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video.